game is getting entirely too simple for you.
Oh, I see. You're going to quit on your champion.
Yes, it is, Mr. Fleming. I'll get you more films.
I'd like to get you alone. Do you mind if I cut you out of the station, girl?
Of course not, Penelope.
Oh, thank you.
But you've been fine to ever since we left New York.
Lovely.
That fellow Fleming seems to be doing all right.
Yeah, what's he got that I haven't got?
A father with $1 million.
I guess that's it.
I could be allergic to work, too, if I had someone to finance a permanent vacation.
Where are we?
Well, I don't know. Oh, Stuart, what port is this?
Rosarita, sir.
Did we stay here long?
2 hours. Mm-hmm.
Just a stop. Thank you.
Rosarita. Notice where it's Yerba mate plantation. Mate is a tea made from the toasted crushed leaves of an evergreen tree belonging to the holly family, which grows wild. Oh. It grows wild in the immense forest patch and has also been intensely cultivated for export to foreign countries and more recently to the United States, where it is finding increasing favor. Rosarita mate is said to have a stronger aroma and more pleasing taste than.
Excited?
I can hardly wait.
We have time to visit all the quaint little gift shops.
Well, don't you think we'd probably have more time to do that on the return trip?
Well, there's no extra charge to see the scenery twice, you know.
That's the trouble with these pleasure cruises. They give you too much for your money. I've got scenic indigestion already.
But this is such a quaint little place.
It'll be 20 days quainter when we get back.
Do you always procrastinate?
Not if I can postpone it.
Mr. Fleming, you're just priceless.
Have a pint, senor. Or tell me not to look. You'll tell him with
everything. Aren't you going ashore, Mr. Fleming?
I believe I will.
Good. You've changed your mind. I'll get my hat and meet you at the gangplank.
I'll keep my eye open for you.
I'm what you call the unexpected guest. I'm terribly sorry. I hope you'll forgive me for barging in so unexpectedly. But you know, when you're cast adrift upon a choppy sea, you don't know just where you'll be washed ashore. But I couldn't have picked a more delightful spot to land if I'd been charting my own course.
Señor, señor, disculpe usted, pero eso no puede ser. Esta mesa está ocupada. ¿No ve usted que está ocupada? Váyase, váyase.
I think you're right. It'll be all, thank you.
Here it is, Mr. I'm afraid I can't introduce you, Ernest. I don't know the gentleman's name.
Richard Fleming of New York. I'm only here for 2 hours, so we didn't wait. I hope you don't mind.
This table is reserved, sir. Will you please leave?
Well, I can't swim. Could you lend me a pair of oars?
I wish you would stop annoying us.
Hey, skipper, weigh anchor. There's a storm brewing in these parts.
Si, senor, si. Fresh. Oh, but he apologized so very
much. I don't understand you. He's the rudest man I've ever seen.
But Alex, perhaps he has not had the advantage of European dress and training.
You best of any key. You must have changed your clothes. Come on, come on.
La la la, can you play me good singing? La la la, there's a song in the breeze. Let's rejoice with the laughter it's bringing. Lend your voice to the gay harmony. Who can fail with the song that is ringing? Up the scale, the rainy patois. Don't despair, join the frolic and lose your care. There is happiness everywhere when you call la la.
La la la, can you
hear me
singing?
La la la, there's a song in the breeze.
La la la, let's enjoy the laughter it brings.
Buenas tardes, señor.
How do you do? My name is Richard Fleming. I'm from New York.
I'm happy to offer to you the hospitality of my estancia.
Thank you.
Why you making faces all the time, eh? Why you no sing?
What are you going to sing about? What's anybody going to sing about?
But it's when you're going to get more money. I know.
What you know?
I've been sent to Fleming to see Don Miguel.
Who's Senor Fleming?
Multi-millionaire from New York. He's going to buy Don Miguel's market.
Yeah, what good that going to do? Come and buy market, too. But what he pay? Nothing.
Oh, no, no. My friend, good fellow. He's got enough money to chuck up Panama Canal. I hear him say, what I care about price. I bet you everyone going to get paid more money. It's going to be great things. Everybody going to be rich.
You like my mate, eh?
Excellent, senor. Excellent.
Oh, I'm very pleased.
How do you find the mate business?
Well, it could be better.
I understand you grow so much you don't know what to do with it.
No, senor. I have enough. That is my daughter. Oh, you have a daughter.
No.
And a pleasant surprise, Senorita. Again we meet by chance.
Yes, again we meet by chance.
Oh, you know my daughter. Oh, yes, indeed.
It was the accident I told you about, Father.
But so far we haven't been properly introduced.
This is Senor Fleming, my daughter, Juanita.
Now, I hope that makes everything perfectly proper.
What could be more proper than having a gentleman introduced by one's own father?
You are in Rosarita on business?
Yes. A combination of business and pleasure.
I hope you will like it here.
I'm sure I will.
Senor Fleming has just said that he thinks that the quality of our mate is best that he has ever tasted.
It is by far the very best.
Father has waited for a long time to settle your country.
Oh, there's no question about it in the United States. They'll love it. It has such a delicious bouquet.
Senor Fleming, I must talk to you about this further.
I say.
Just saw Judge Watero see.
Very interesting.
Fleming, what Juanita says. I have waited a long time to settle in the United States.
Well, really, I only wish to buy the very smallest quantity.
Oh, of course. Of course, I shall send you as little as you desire. Have 500 gold cuts, if you take them.
Well, I thought maybe 200 gold cuts.
See, it shall be as you say. And you shall have it for 25 pesos a gold cut.
Well, Don Miguel, don't you think that's a little high? I thought maybe 20 pesos a boat.
Well, for this first shipment, it makes no difference, amigo. Whatever you say. You are pleased with the bargain?
Oh, yes. I'm very happy.
I should like to discuss with you, Senor Fleming.
Well, now that my business is disposed of, I guess I'd better run along. Goodbye.
Adios, senor.
Until we meet again.
Hasta la vista.
You laugh because you are happy, no?
You're right. No.
Pretty funny, senor.
You're right again, Roberto. And the joke's on me. 200 bolsters at 20 pesos a bolster? Why, that's $1,000, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I see. I sure hope my credit's still good with my old man.
Sure, Don Miguel's mate will not be enough. We can get 2,000 bolsters from Gonzalez.
At what price?
15 pesos per bolsa. Shall we take it?
No. Not at his price. At our price.
Excuse me, senor. But we have not enough to take care of this order.
Oh, I see. Raskin has increased again.
Sí, senor. We have received increased orders from everybody.
Good. Good.
And more inquiries from the United States, too, asking for quotation.
Ignore them. I'm not ready for that, Father.
But, senor, you have waited too long for the United States market. It's been a mistake, I think.
I do the thinking, dear. I pay you to do what I tell you, not to think.
But don't you realize, sir, that...
Make it. I realize that business is based on supply and demand. First, I must get the source of supply under my
absolute control. And when I'm able to buy everything I want on my own terms, then I'll take care of the demand at a good profit.
Yes, sir. And while you're waiting for the growers to meet your terms, a buyer has already arrived from the United States.
What is that you say?
A Mr. Richard Fleming from New York is here now in Rosarita.
What?
He's already bought from Dan McGill.
At what price?
20 pesos a bull.
Why, that's double what I pay.
That's just what I've been trying to tell you.
Voy a preguntar a ver en dónde ponemos la hierba.
Está bien.
Señora.
Señora.
¿Qué? Hierba mate para el señor Fleming.
¿Señor Fleming? El cuarto número 6.
¿Cómo? ¿Que pongamos todo esta hierba en el cuarto número 6?
Sí, el cuarto número 6. Váyase, por favor, déjame dormir. Allí mando yo.
Ah, bueno, no se enoje. La señora que está adentro dice que pongamos la hierba en el cuarto número 6.
¿Qué? ¿Quiere decir que pongamos todas estas bolsas de hierba en el cuarto de un hotel?
En el cuarto número 6.
¿Pero a quién se le ocurre eso? ¡Esa señora está!
¡6! ¿Cómo vamos a poner estas bolsas en el cuarto número 6?
Ah, bueno, cuarto número 6.
Abajo.
Mate.
Hey, what are you for? This isn't a storeroom.
Plumbing, sir.
Oh, that's a help. Don't bring any more of that stuff in here.
Do when I buy a taxi, huh?
When I sell my taxi, I bet you I'm going to sleep for 3 months.
You know, if I had 600 pesos, I bet you I'd give it to you all at one time. Then I own it right away.
And I bet you it's going to be, I got 50 grandchildren before you pay me.
I bet you.
Oh, save your money.
Already I give you 60 pesos, and today I'm going to give you whatever I make.
You know what I say? You don't pay me 600 pesos before la fiesta de San Jacinto? I keep all you pay in my taxi, too.
Yeah, I know you say that. But all the same, I'm going to buy your taxi shoes.
Yeah, just like you say, you catch 3 fish all at one time.
Well, sure I catch.
How you catch 3 fish? All on one hook?
Well, anyway, I do it.
There is room enough on one hook for 3 fish.
It's a big hook.
It's a big lie.
Yeah, I tell you true.
Oh, all this time you dream too much.
You, Roberto, what are you doing?
$15 What for?
For
a boat to see my motorcycle.
It's Rosarita. And I beg you not to go so fast. Please, you broke one table and 3 chairs. And pretty soon you won't break your neck.
I don't break motorcycle. I go slow like you tell me.
Hmm?
Sure, I tell you true. You're Fleming. All the time, tell me a horror. This is Hotel La Paloma, quick. I tell him I am sorry. I cannot go fast because my mother does not want me to break my neck. As we can. Keep telling me go faster, go fast.
He's in a hurry, huh?
Oh, yes. I asked him why he takes a big hurry. He's in all trouble. Most beautiful senorita is waiting for him. I must get that quick. Very quick.
And due to my unusual bravery and amazing sense of balance used by thousands of wheelbarrow races, I was able to maneuver the sidecar right up to the senorita's table.
the very spot where it seems I was going.
It was a miracle. No matter what happened, Roberto is never to blame. Papa would be very proud of me. Very.
Oh, his father was also a man of great chivalry.
Papa, he was the biggest liar in no Rosarito.
Well, Roberto, I've got 20 days on my hands. Do you think between us we could drum up another little adventure?
Maybe you need dice.
Yeah, that's a very good idea. The price is right. How about $1 a day?
Oh, senor, no, I know I'm going to own that taxi, sure.
Taxi?
Si, senor. I'm just going to buy Manuel taxi. It costs 600 pesos. Already I've been 64.
Only 536 more to go.
Si?
Ah, that's going to be easy.
It's going to be easy enough, senor.
Now that you're my guy, you think you could guide me to that beautiful senorita I met yesterday?
I do not think you can meet senorita. You do not know her father.
Well, I didn't have any trouble yesterday, now did I? Remember, you guided me right up to her table.
Oh, yes, I know, senor, but that was an accident.
Well, I'm not particular. Let's have another accident.
I don't know.
Say, with that imagination of yours, anything might happen. Even a miracle. Yes, sir, with 3 weeks on my hands, I sure ought to go to town.
Senorita only comes to town not too many times.
Well, if the mountains won't come to Muhammad, Muhammad will go to the mountains. Well, skipper, everything shipshape?
Si, senor.
Away anchor and we'll set sail for uncharted seas.
Gentlemen,
you know, I'm not unimportant in the community.
You're very necessary to the community.
And I'm quite comfortable financially.
Yes, I know. You're a very rich man.
Yet, always when I'm serious with you.
But that is just a trouble, senor. You're always serious.
I'm afraid I have delayed.
Yes, Father, and Senor Komac has been waiting for you all. You will excuse me?
I've been trying to find a way to help you, my friend. But so far, I do not know the way.
But it is several weeks since you promised to take my money. The new crop is now in, and I must dispose of it.
That's too bad. But I have more than I need. There's not much demand.
What? Senor Komac, you say to me that I should grow more money for you. You need it. You will take it.
I'm sorry I overestimated the market.
Then you will not buy it.
Since I have given you my word, I shall buy all you have. For 10 pesos of all time.
But that is not enough to pay my cerbateros and it costs a million.
Friend, I cannot help it. There is too much money. Do you not wish to sell for me?
Oh, it is hard to take the price you offer.
One thing I promise. When my business gets better, then I shall pay more.
We will work together and help each other, eh?
Always I do my best for you. You should be convinced of that.
Si, si.
I told Juanita so, too.
Si.
But I do not convince her.
Yes, I know, amigo, but that you understand is another matter.
Si. I understand. Well,
Adios.
Adios, senor.
Who does that guy think he is?
Senor Komac. He comes here all the time. He buys matches from down the hill.
Oh, so that's how he rates the front door.
See, Don Miguel will much money. He goes so much, he don't know what to do with it.
You don't say. Why didn't you tell me this before?
You know, ask me.
Skipper, this match thing interests me strangely. I think I'll have a talk to Don Miguel about it.
You mean you're going to buy Marty?
I said I was going to talk about it. Come to think of it, Marty is becoming my chief interest in life.
Oh, why you don't tell me?
You don't ask
me. If you buy Marty from Don Miguel, he's going to sell it to you very cheap, I bet you.
Price is no object for land. Or for that matter, is the Marty.
Oh, senor. That's going to make Don Miguel very happy you buy his Marty. And my friends who work here, too. And maybe so you're going to be telling it, huh?
You catch on pretty fast, Roberto.
Buenas tardes, Roberto.
I'll send you Fleming, bien hablar con Don Miguel respecto al mate.
Está bien.
You don't need me anymore, senor?
I think I can spare you now, Roberto.
Okay, I'm going to see my friend Pedro.
Por aquí, senor.
Senora. Senora.
Hey.
I should like to see Senor Fleming.
Senor Fleming?
Yes.
What?
That's it.
Roberto, Mrs. Ramos, Roberto!
Say, how long is this going on? Now get out of here and stay out! The next guy that comes in here is going to get this right in his face. Oh. Beg your pardon. I thought you were a sack of mate.
I am Alexander Komac.
I apologize. I'm terribly sorry.
It is nothing.
I've been trying to keep these fellows from playing soldier, but they're determined to barricade my room against an air raid. Won't you sit down? Thank you.
You did not think I would discover your secret so soon.
Oh, have you? Yes.
No longer necessary to hide it in your room.
Oh, that? Well, I hope not.
You see, I am in the mate business, too, and for a very long time. Here is what I need.
Good. I'm looking for a customer. You want to buy this, I'll make you a very good bargain.
I'm afraid you have already ruined the market price in Rosarita.
Have I? How unfortunate.
I have worked very hard for many years to establish what is a fair price.
It would be so much better for both of us if you would go elsewhere.
Yes?
Well, I don't like to be pushed around.
Oh. So you are going to remain in Rosarito?
Oh, sure. I like it here. I think it's very attractive.
Well, if you are determined to stay, maybe we can, what you call in your country, play a little ball.
No, I don't mean this literally. Oh, I think I get you now. You mean about the,
Precisely.
But come to think about it, wouldn't that be a combination in restraint of trade? You know, the Sherman antitrust law.
Oh. You make a joke with me?
I was never more serious in my life.
I'm sorry we don't see these matters eye to eye. I think you are a little stupid.
I think you're a big chiseler. That is an insult.
Oh, it's not so hot.
I could do a lot better if I gave it some thought.
Oh.
You want to play, huh?
Round one, Roberto.
Well, if the mountains still go to Mormon, The rotten country is dead off Larry. Oh, I almost forgot. They're a cobblegum company.
Thank you, Skipper. Yeah, good news, no.
Oh. Well, I hope you're going to get all the matzo you want.
But this is enough for the moment. I'll find some place to put the rest of it.
Okay, I'll fix you up.
Hello?
Your New York call is ready. Hold on, New York. Go ahead, Mr. Fleming.
Hello, Harry? Harry, listen.
How are all the girls down in South America? Said he doesn't want his father to know.
Yeah, I can understand that all right.
Yeah, and is he sore at you? What do you expect me to do with this stuff? Throw it out the window at the next ticker tape parade? Well, would it make good fodder for my polo ponies? Why don't you burn it up? Call the phone. He can't burn it up. Everybody will think he's an imposter. They expect him to ship it. Huh? Uh-oh. I knew there was a girl in it somewhere. He wants the girl to think he's an imposter. Huh? Oh, importer, not imposter. Hey, Dick, I got a great idea. We'll get Elsa Maxwell to stage a Boston Tea Party. Yeah, how do you like that? Hello. Hello, Dick. Hey, Dick. Hey. He hung up.
What do we do with this stuff, whatever you call it, anyhow?
Well, why not ring up Carol Young? He deals in coffee and cocoa and tea and all that junk. Tell him we're giving him a break.
Yeah, and what a break.
Miguel, pretty lucky, huh?
Sick. I got too much matter myself. I sure like to have fortune smile on me the same way.
I fixed that for you like I fixed for Don Miguel. Did your Fleming say he's gonna buy all the mate in Rosarito?
Oh, you know?
I hear him say that. Oh, he sure go to the town with Senor Komac. He tell him 10 things or two. He's gonna take all he can get and more too. And pay big price.
See, this is good. If he buys our mate, this will be one big thing for Rosarito.
Senor Fleming do big thing for us. I think we do big thing for him. Next week is La Fiesta, no?
Yes.
And Senor Fleming is a hero?
Yes.
Then I think maybe on Fiesta Day we give him one big bump with speeches.
Sí. Tendremos que hacer algo grande.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis. Cinco.
Don't do that to the car. What's the matter with you?
530 more pesos, and she is mine.
You don't forget. You only got till La Fiesta de San Jacinto. You remember what we said?
Fiesta's not till next week. You don't worry.
No, I don't worry.
Mañana's another day.
Please, mañana's another day.
Well, you want me, senor?
Why, yes. Roberto, I need your advice. Now tell me, in your country, when a man wants to make a hit with a beautiful senorita, how does he go about it? I mean, what does he do?
Why, he serenades her.
Más profundo y más grande en este mundo
el cariño que te di. Bésame con un beso enamorado, como nadie me ha besado desde el día en que nací. Sabrás la amargura que estoy sufriendo por ti. Así sabrás la amargura que estoy sufriendo.
That I were a glove upon thy hand, that I might touch thy cheek.
You all right, senor?
I don't know, Roberto. I'm afraid I have broken my guitar.
You're hurt, senor?
Deeply, deeply. Es una linda mañana, senorita.
Roberto, you do not teach your friend so good Spanish. He says it's a beautiful morning. When the moon is shining brightly.
Oh, is there a moon tonight? A muy grande moon. And I see you're not going to waste it. You're dressed for riding, aren't you?
Roberto, tell Pedro to saddle a horse for us, senor.
Si, senorita.
Shall we?
Why not?
Thank you.
Shelton.
Yes, that's fine, Roberto. But don't you know it's bad manners to follow people around?
But I only give you seven names, like you say.
Yes, of course, sir. I'm going to be the envy of every man at the fiesta tonight. I have the honor of escorting the most beautiful girl in Rosarita. I should say in South America.
Gracias, senor.
I was going to say in the whole world. In fact, I will say it. The most beautiful girl in the whole world.
I'm sure you speak with a great deal of experience, senor.
Perhaps you're right. From an entirely different world.
Senor,
you are a hero,
no?
Oh, this is one great
day, Rosarita,
Senor Fleming.
Senor Fleming.
Ah, Miguel.
Juanita. For you, Senor Fleming, the seat of honor.
Oh, thank you, thank you. What is all this fuss about? I mean, what have I done?
You do not know?
Roberto, el Senor is very modest.
Agradecida lo saluda y entrega este precioso mate y bombilla con adornos de oro.
We want you to make a speech.
Me?
Sí.
Oh. My friends, I'm deeply honored, but I don't know why you're honoring me. But I'm overcome to find an American given such a reception in such... After all, this is America too, isn't it? There's been a lot of talk about uniting the goodwill of North and South America. But have we really done much about it? I'm afraid not. That gives me an idea. What we should do is to get better acquainted. Do more trading with each other. Unite the goodwill of our people and really put America on the map. I thank you.
Oh, Richard, your feet were wonderful. My heart is filled with happiness.
And it should be, as you say, our two countries must combine with goodwill and understanding.
Yes, Senor Fleming. What you have said about our mutual trade has given the Rosarito cause for great rejoicing. All of our growers have united into one organization, and they have authorized me to say to you that all the mate that we have to sell, we will sell only to you.
Mate?
Hola, saluda, Senor Fleming.
Salud. Viva.
Don Miguel, I didn't just... What made you think that... Oh, I've got to talk to you alone. Juanita, excuse us. Don Miguel, I don't know how to say this to you, but I'm afraid I'm on the spot.
What do you mean, amigo, on the spot?
Well, your kind people have gone overboard in making me a hero.
Ah, you proved yourself a friend.
You see, my stay here in your beautiful country has been misunderstood. Actually, I know nothing of this mate you grew.
What you say, I don't understand. Roberto has said that...
Oh, I don't know what Roberto has said, but whatever it is, it's sure to be an exaggeration.
But you have come to me yourself and buy from me.
I'd like to explain that to you. See, the mate I bought was all I intended to buy. As a matter of fact, I had no use for that.
Still, I do not understand.
Don Miguel, I first saw your daughter in the cafe, and I was anxious to be introduced to her formally.
I think I understand now. Adios, senor. Juanita, we go now.
But, Father, why do we go so soon?
Please.
¿Qué ha pasado con Miguel?
El señor Fleming no va a comprar nuestro mate.
No, ¿y por qué?
Ese hombre es un estafador.
No puede ser.
Juanita.
Señor Fleming. Señor. ¿Es something the matter, señor?
I'm afraid there is, Roberto. I'm in a mess.
Hello, Skipper. Say, will you take care of my hotel bill for me? Here. Whatever's left over is yours.
It's too much, brother. I make so much trouble for you.
Forget it, Roberto. It's all my fault.
Oh, no, no. I hope what you say got the wrong slant. I go to the wrong town.
You better run along now, Roberto.
You go on boat when she come back, huh?
I'm afraid so.
I feel sorry that you make bad friends with Senorita. I think you feel pretty bad about that. And I bet she's gonna feel bad about that, too.
Oh, I don't know.
Maybe I tell her it's all my fault. Think you're gonna like her again, huh?
Oh, no, Roberto. It's a lost cause.
Well, maybe it'd make you feel good if we take riding motorcycle and see the country. You'd like to go to rubber plantation, huh?
Hey, wait a minute. What do you want me to do, take home a rubber plantation, too? No, Roberto, it looks like I won't need you anymore.
No more guide?
No more guide.
Boom. Like all my toxin.
San Rafael. El aeroplano sale de San Rafael. You get the plane in San Rafael.
How do I get there?
We arrange for you to go in auto. It is only 40 miles.
Would you be kind enough to tell the purser on the boat of my change of plans?
Certainly, senor.
Thank you.
I tell you, I know it worked out this way. I always say you dream too much.
Well, anyhow, I give you 70 pesos.
Anyhow, you know what I say.
Yeah, I know. If I don't pay you all of it yesterday, you can keep all of the money and the taxi too.
Well, what you think? That's what I'm gonna do.
That's all right, Manuel. You good sport. You keep your word.
Sure, Manuel always keep his word.
Oye, Manuel, I have fare for you. Do you want to go to San Rafael?
Si, si.
It seems that Senor Fleming will not buy mate at any time.
No?
No, senor.
Muchacho, lleve este mensaje enseguida.
¿Quién?
Telegrama para el señor Richard Fleming.
Roberto, Roberto, have you seen Mr. Fleming anywhere?
No, senorita, I do not know where he is. I wait for him here.
Oh, I'm so afraid he'll miss the boat again. Be a dear boy and go find him quick, will you?
Okay. Señor Fleming. Señor Fleming. Señor.
Fleming canceled his reservation.
Oh, he's not going?
No, he's going on the plane.
Huh? Oh, but this is terrible. Well, this cablegram might be important.
Well, you're not
going to
need it.
Oh, viva! Amigos, amigos, all United States going to buy mate. Senor Fleming, easy.
Oh, well, you've got to stop him.
No, no.
You come with me, quick, please.
But why, Roberto?
Well, I think if you tell him not to go, he don't go. He likes you very much, and you say don't go. He don't go.
It's no good, Roberto.
Because of you, they do.
Do what?
No, no, no. I do not tell you. Make you too excited.
Roberto, I insist you tell me at once.
It's going to be too bad if someone gets hurt. Oh, it is terrible. First he hit him with gloves. Then he tear off fingers, one by one, and throw them in his face.
Who are you talking about?
Senor Komac. Oh, he is very mad. So mad that he hits Senor Fleming in face.
glow.
Are you trying to tell me they're going to fight a duel or something like that?
Oh, I am sure.
Did you?
Well, they're going to do it. And you know, Senor Komac, he's the best pistola shot in all Rosarita.
All right, I go with you.
Roberto, what are you doing here?
I bring Senorita in taxi. She wants to see you and say goodbye.
Hey, what are you talking about?
Not Senorita.
Please, Senor Fleming, the plane she's going. We cannot wait.
Hold it a minute, please.
Senor Fleming, he is not going. All United States is going to buy what? He's going to stay here.
See?
See, I tell you through.
Gracias, muchacho.
Juanita.
You will please take me back in a hurry.
Si, senorita.
Oh, wait a minute, Juanita. What's this all about? You came down to see me off and now you're leaving. I don't understand.
It is all a mistake. Roberto has told me a lie. He said that you and Senor Komac are going to fight a duel.
Oh, then you were a little bit interested.
Naturally. I did not wish to see Senor Komac get shot.
That's a fine thing.
I teach it.
All right, little fixer, what do I do now?
You go back to Rosarita and work. All United States, what not?
Go to work? Roberto, that's the first logical idea you've had. Work. Why not? And now, may I ride back with you in my taxi cab?
But this is my taxi cab. Is that not so, Manuel?
Si.
Oh, but you brought me out here to the airport.
Si.
But I have engaged you to take me back.
Si.
But that way you get double fares, one from each of us.
Si.
No, this is my taxi cab exclusive.
Si.
But I have priority rights, haven't I?
Si.
But I insist it is my taxi cab.
Si.
Si, 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 si. Now, wait a minute. I'll settle this.
See,
it is now Roberto's taxi cab. Get in, skipper.
Gracias, senor. You are a fine man. From now on, I'm going to work for you for nothing.
Not a chance. I'm afraid even that would be too expensive.
Tra-la-la, and ready for singing. Tra-la-la, there's a song in the breeze. Rejoice, with the laughter it's bringing. Lend your voice to the gay harmony. Whoop and bear, with a song that is ringing. Up the scale, do re mi fa sol la.